There are a lot of new things here at BHS. The gym has a new floor and a new elevator. The main entrance is getting some bedazzle. And now let's go inside the main entrance to see our new athletic director, Shaun Hart.
This is not Mr. Hart's first go around as an athletic director. Shaun told us some of his work history.
I actually started with teaching in Westford. I was a physical education teacher in Westford. And then I went from there. I was a football / lacrosse coach there. Mm-hmm. Took the AD job in Revere in 2010, mm-hmm. was there until hired here in April, and then started July 1.
One of the first things on Mr. Hart's agenda was to meet with all the coaches here at BHS.
Coaches were tremendously receptive, very, very helpful, and it's been, I wish this is the way it goes for everybody.
Mr. Hart has used social media as a way to communicate with athletes, parents, and fans. During his first meeting with the coaches, he made sure that they had that as a priority as well.
You know, we had a coaches meeting, as I said earlier, and I think it's really important to be able to bring out some information when in a timely, updated fashion. So we elected as an athletic staff to use the Twitter as our kind of our way of getting out there, you know.
Mr. Hart shared with us how some of the coaches that were new to Twitter reacted to the choice.
For some of the coaches that had never used social media, it's a little daunting at first, but you know, when you tell a coach that they could write down a score, write a highlight, use a couple of players who had a great game, and they can attach that to two or three or four newspapers and media outlets, and then they don't have to do anything else because everyone follows it, everybody retweets it. So I think they realized quickly how easy it really was, and it's been great. And I think that every varsity coach for the fall has joined Twitter, all have their own accounts now, and we have our athletic department feed that will just retweet everything they do.
I then asked the all-important question, how did this year's teams look?
I think I was at football versus Newton North, a very good Division I opponent. And I thought that Burlington, they handled themselves very well. I thought athletically we are tremendously quick and we'll use that quickness. I know last year, after doing a little bit of watching video and a little bit of watching the team, I mean, they were young and they were, you know, with youth comes, you know, inexperience and having to figure things out. But this year, I don't think any of that showed in scrimmage one. Mm-hmm. I went over and I watched the girls soccer team, again, a young team, but worked tremendously hard. I've seen volleyball on quite a few occasions. They look very, very up and coming. And I think it's going to be a tremendous year for us, a good start off for the fall.
Before leaving, Shaun reminded us that his door was always open.
No, I just want to let everybody know that our door is always open. You know, there are, with a new person coming in, you know, there's a lot of new faces and a lot of new names. And, you know, don't get discouraged. Walk up, say hello, introduce yourself, and I'll remember you. And I'll try and do the best I can to make myself available for you. We'll be out at games. Don't be a stranger. Come up and say hello and, you know, be part of the experience. We want everybody out for everything, and we want to do the best we can to provide a quality opportunity for the kids and for the parents.
Thanks, Mr. Hart, for that interview. From outside BHS, I'm Phil Arcaro, also known as Burley Superfan. Back to you in the studio.